You are watching YEticket.com with Al McGee, movie reviews and interviews. This is YEticket.com, YEticket.com, your entertainment ticket.
We are your entertainment ticket, that's right, YEticket.com. We are your entertainment ticket, that's right, YEticket.com.
Hey, this is Al McGee with your entertainment ticket, but here I'm with the cast of Cabaret here at the Adrian Arch Center. I saw it last night and I was thrilled, and I saw these people on stage. Oh my goodness. And you know, Cabaret is one of my favorite musicals of all time because it's a deep story and the characters are really, really great in this because you won't forget them. Hey, let me stop talking. What's your name and your character?
I'm Lee Aaron Rosen. I play Cliff Bradshaw.
I'm Ned Noyes. I play Ernst Ludwig.
And I'm Allison Ewing. I play Fräulein Kost.
And from our cost, you got a special gift. I say, yeah, if I was a sailor too in Germany, I think I would have looked you up myself. Man. Well, cost, you playing the American, right?
Yes, I am, yeah.
And you're a newspaper guy. And it brought you into Germany just before everything really popped off, right?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Now, your character, why did he come to Germany?
Basically because, as he says in the show that he's looking for something to write about. That's sort of a way of avoiding writing about anything that's truthful to himself, but he's looking for some place to get inspiration. Yeah, and Germany in 1929 was really a good place to find it. And anything goes in Weimar era Berlin, yeah.
Oh yeah, especially if you see this show. And your character, oh my goodness. Yeah. Tell us about your character.
I play Ernst Ludwig, and I meet Cliff on a train. I introduce him to the Kit Kat Club, hook him up with a job, potentially shady smuggling operation. And then it's revealed, I don't want to spoil anything,
yeah,
but yeah, some interesting things happen to this character.
Your character is very interesting. And in fact, I really enjoyed your character because, you know, it's a political season there in 1929. They all try to decide what they want to do and things like that. And you really portrayed that in a good way. Now, how did you find that in yourself to play this character?
I mean, I think, you know, you always have to start from a place of not judging your character. So, you know, what are the issues that I feel passionately about, you know, I have to tap into that, you know, to assimilate it with what my character is feeling. Yeah,
exactly. And Allison, oh my goodness. Wow. Your character is really great. It really is. And it's very colorful too. Now, when you read the script and you auditioned for this character, why did you want to play this person?
Well, she has to do a lot of things. She has to sing and dance, and she's a really gritty character. She's smuggling sailors in and out of her apartment and sneaking around, and she's a dancer at the club, but she's got a lot of deepness to her and a lot of history within herself. She also plays accordion, and so I knew it would just be a really rich, wonderful part to play. She sings a beautiful song called Married in German, and I really wanted to have the chance to play such a flavorful character.
Exactly. Now, this is the first time that the Adrian Arhst Center is bringing on Cabaret, and the audience I was with last night truly, truly enjoyed it. What do you enjoy about it?
I do enjoy doing it every night. I enjoy seeing how different audiences respond differently to it in different cities. I think that there are themes in this show that are unfortunately timely and or perhaps fortunately timeless and deserve to be seen by people who might not otherwise get the chance to see it.
I definitely say they should come see it, and they really deserve to see it. Now, let's talk about yourselves a little bit. Where are you from?
I'm from New York originally, yeah.
Oh, New York originally?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And when did the acting bug bite you?
Pretty early on, you know. I did all those school plays and musicals. And
really?
Yeah, yeah. I started working professionally while I was in college.
Oh, yeah. Nice. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm from Iowa, actually. And ooh. Yeah.
I've been there.
It's a long way from Iowa to New York, I'll tell you that. But I grew up in a children's theater. I was lucky enough to have a children's theater in our town, and I just started very, very young.
Wow. And I am from New Jersey.
And were you a kid actor like these two?
I did a little bit in summer camp, but didn't really think too seriously about it until high school.
Oh, and that's when the girls liked you more, didn't they?
Well, that is also true, yes. Yeah, yeah. I also like doing it for its own sake, but that was not a bad perk of the work. Yeah.
I know. Well, you know, they're telling me time is up, but I tell you this, I enjoyed the show. I enjoyed you. Thank you very much, Allison. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And the show is great. Hey, come see these people. When you see them on stage, they won't look like this. They'll look better and bigger. Well, yeah, she will. But they look bigger and better. Hey, I'm Al McGee here at the Adrian Arts Center. Cabaret, cabaret. Thank you. Cabaret, one of my favorite musicals. And this musical, haven't been here since 2000. Wow, 16 years. It's finally back here at the Adrian Arts Center. But these two people here really bring it to life. And your name is?
Randy Harrison. Andrea Goss.
Randy and Andrea. And now tell us your character.
I play the MC. I'm the host of the Cabaret Club.
And I play Sally Bowles. She is a British singer at the Cabaret Club.
Wow. And she's really, really a person who really loves to be an entertainer, right?
Yes, she loves to perform, not just on stage, but kind of in her everyday life. She is a performer through and through. Yes.
She is. And you really interpret that actor, I mean, that character. I thought it was so real the way you did it on stage. What brought that out within you to bring that character to life?
Well, I think for me, it always comes down to the writing, actually. You know, I mean, there's always a part of me in every single character, but she's a 19-year-old who loves to perform. She's charismatic and fun and energetic, but underneath it, you know, she's kind of a scared child, and the writing is incredible. So for me, I think it's like an easier job because the writing is already there for me.
And the MC is really the person who really is the glue that holds the show together.
Yeah.
Why do you like this character?
I like this character because I think he's smart and subversive, and it's a really empowering role because I'm kind of the intermediary between the audience and everything that's happening on stage. So I can kind of try to skew the audience's perception, and I move some of the plot forward. It's just a thrilling part to be able to play.
But the way you transform yourself into that character, I mean, if people were to see you now and then see the character, they wouldn't believe it's you. How did you be able to say, let me switch back and forth?
I think it happens piece by piece. It's, it's a different accent. Right. I think that changes me. And then speaking in a different voice on stage starts to change the way that you sound. And then the makeup and costuming is radically different. You know, I'm paled out like a ghost white and have
yes.
these crazy eyes. It really, it's a contribution with all the designers and the writing and my work. It all comes together to sort of create this other creature.
And you know, this takes place in Germany in 1929 and then the progress of years later at the Kit Kat Club, right?
Yep.
And, sometimes people, you know, see the writing on the wall and things like that. But I love that club. I want to go to one right now.
It's a fun club. The music is great. The dancing is wonderful. Yes. It's gritty. It's fun. And, yeah, there's nothing like it.
No, nothing like it at all. Nothing like it today.
That's for sure.
Why do you like this story?
I think it's important. It's relevant that we examine this time period and examine sort of what was the social and political situation that gave rise to the Third Reich, and sort of not act like it's something that's completely separate from where we are now, but acknowledge that these are realities in human history that could recur. I just think that that's important, and to do it with incredible music and incredible, you know, numbers and massive amounts of humor and entertainment is just invaluable, I think.
Same for you?
Yeah, I think the story is completely, sadly, relevant still today.
And sure
Yeah, and I think, though, it is written in such a way, though, that the audience doesn't know what they're seeing at first. It's fun, it's funny, it's charming, but then they're slowly brought into the story even more, so by the end, I think it hits them more what it's really about. And I, you know, we do go out of the stage door every day, and I still hear people talking about it and how powerful it was, and that's, I think that is what the story that we want to do is change people and affect people and make people think.
That's one thing I love about Cabaret. Wow, I can sit up and talk to you guys all day, but, you know, I gotta go. But make sure you go and see Cabaret. You'll see these two wonderful actors here, and it's great. I'm Al McGee with your entertainment ticket. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.
Al McGee with your entertainment ticket. I'm here at the Adrian Arts Center, and I just saw Cabaret, and I just saw these two actors play in it. I couldn't believe my ears and my eyes. It was a full palette, and their characters, oh my goodness. First of all, let's meet them. What's your name?
My name is Shannon Cochran.
Mark Nelson.
Now, Shannon, what's the name of the character that you played last night?
I play Fräulein Schneider.
Yeah, she's a woman, older single woman in 1929 Germany who owns a boarding house. And man, she really went through it. Why do you like this character?
I like her because she was somebody who had to make some choices to survive, and she's like an early feminist. She's sort of on her own trying to make it in the world.
And you played Herschel Schultz, and you own a fruit store, Mr. Schultz.
That's correct. Yeah. Italian oranges.
Yeah. And also, why you like this character?
I like this character.
I know, right? Oh,
I wouldn't.
I know. Now, when you auditioned for this play,
yes, sir.
And you saw the character that you were auditioning for,
yeah.
How did you say to yourself, well, how can I transform this from me to Schultz?
It wasn't hard, you know. He speaks to me. I believe in what Schultz believes in. And he's a champion of love, and he's told by the world that he's living in that he doesn't belong, and he decides to ignore that and defy it and lead a full life.
Yes, and he fell in love with this lovely woman right here.
And who wouldn't understand that?
Oh. That's right, you know, especially in this musical that you all really brought this out in this musical, Cabaret. Now, they haven't had Cabaret here at the Adrian Arhst Center for 16 years. I think it was a 2000. Man, that's great to see you guys on stage with this particular play. Now, what would you tell someone about Cabaret?
Well, I would say there's something for everyone in Cabaret. There's beautiful, sexy women dancing in scanty clothing. There's a lot of great songs, some of which they know maybe this time, and Cabaret, of course, the song. And there's a kind of political thread that runs through it that exactly kind of shows what's going on in our country today. And
yes.
I think there's a message in there. Mm-hmm. It's a pretty powerful tale.
Yeah. And what message would you say that's in this?
Well, I'll use my character's words. He says, it's not always a good thing to settle for the lowest apple on the tree, the one that's easiest to reach. Climb up a little way, it's worth it. And that's the message that I would hope America hears as we travel around with this play. I'm hoping passionately that we don't settle for the lowest apple on the tree.
Exactly. I enjoyed those words when I heard them last night, but also the words too from your character's mouth. I've been through it. I've been through everything, but I'm still going to survive. Is that how you feel in real life?
Absolutely. I'll still be here churning it out 8 times a week.
That's right. So you both really enjoy playing together, right?
Totally. I wouldn't be doing this without Shannon.
Now, it's really hard to fit two actors together who really like each other, too. So is that what's going on here, too?
We got very lucky. We were just saying when we met one another, I think there was an instant connection, and that made everything easy. You know, once you find out you've got a soulmate or something, you know you're going to be okay.
They had to really search for someone tall enough for me.
You're absolutely right. Now, let's switch a little bit. Let's talk about you, your real selves. Where are you from?
I'm originally from Savannah, Georgia.
Oh, great.
I grew up in North Carolina, and I sort of split my time now between Los Angeles and Chicago.
Ooh. That's my hometown. Why Chicago?
Because it's the greatest theater town in the whole country.
Yeah, that's where I started.
Yeah, yeah. I just love everything about it, the restaurants, the museums,
Ooh.
The music, the sports.
Oh, yeah.
So,
exactly.
Yeah. It's my spiritual home.
In L.A., I love L.A. too.
It's all right.
I'm from Jersey, from Westwood, New Jersey.
I've never been there.
Well, it's close enough to New York City that I was lying at the age of 6 about being from New York.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I got one glimpse of New York. My parents took me to Radio City, and from that moment on, I knew I was a New Yorker.
And is that the time, too, when they used to take you to New York, they used to say, hey, I want to be an actor?
I didn't dare say that in my family, but I just kept it secret and sprung it on them later.
And now they're really happy for you, right?
Yeah, they eventually came around.
And also, how old are you when you got the bug?
You know, I came to it kind of late. I was planning to do something else and make a really good living. but I just kind of backed into it. I kept thinking, well, when I don't have work, then I'll go back to law school. And then I just kept getting work. So I one day I woke up and said, I guess I'm an actor.
I understand. I hear a lot of different stories. Everyone's different as far as, you know, getting the acting bug or getting bitten. I mean, you know, but I'm glad you all got bitten because I'm glad to see you and glad to meet you. Thank you very much
Thank
for coming
you.
On your entertainment Thank ticket you, and also your powerful acting on stage to really makes this a great musical, Cabaret.
Thank you so
That's
much.
Lovely. Right. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Come to see Cabaret at the Adrian Arhst Center here in Miami. Wow. You're going to be thrilled just like I am and always will be.
Latest and greatest movie.